you sit down with your first deck and you go, cool, I have a creature, I can attack, I can block, I can maybe do a lightning strike.
I was playing Magic 3 years before I played in a GP.
I was playing Magic around 5 years before I went to my first GP.
The basics are simple, but after you've learned the basics, it can get hard.
For about a year and a half, maybe?
About 4 years.
So what Aoife is doing is a bit, I would say, difficult.
6 weeks of practice? Ooh, it's tough.
I think it's a great experience for someone who's just starting to play Magic.
I feel like as you go on, it continues to get more and more difficult, but that's mainly because of skill.
I'm sure if you sat down with Reed Duke for 6 weeks, you might be fine.
Magic is a game that takes time to learn. Like you don't expect to just show up at a Grand Prix and like roll people. Like, it doesn't work like that.
No, probably not. But the main thing is to have fun at your first GP.
Oh, they'll scrub out.
Like if you put in the effort, yeah, I think you can do pretty well.
It's gonna be a ride.
I've played like 3 games, and that's about it.
Sure. And what's the plan? You're playing in a GP?
Yeah, so the Seattle one.
Oh, you're going to Seattle. Okay.
Yeah, so that's April. So that's exciting. So I have like 6 weeks to actually be functionally able to play. So yeah.
Do you know what you're playing yet?
Like as in the deck, is it?
Are you looking to maybe get some advice on maybe which one you should play?
Actually, that would be brilliant. Yeah.
I think if you're that new to Magic, like literally played 3 games or something, I would probably recommend Mono Red.
Okay.
And the reason I would recommend that is because, I mean, honestly, like any deck that you find to be your playstyle, I think is a good option.
Yeah.
But with this one in particular, if you're so new to the format,
yeah.
Something I recommend whenever people are joining, whether it be standard, modern, legacy, vintage, it doesn't matter what the format is. If they're really, really brand new to it, a lot of times the best advice is to pick a deck that's not super interactive so that you can do your game plan all the time and not worry as much about what your opponent is doing.
I think that's probably the one thing that I'm struggling with the most because like when I'm playing, I'm trying to think of what I want to do, but then I'm also thinking like, oh, but what are they going to do when I do this? So I'm like, oh, it's like all jumbled up. Like,
I think the one piece of advice that I think everybody who plays Magic has heard at some point, and it really is, I think the best advice is read the card does what the card says it does.
Yeah.
It's so easy to just kind of glance at it and be like, oh yeah, it does this thing and not really think about it too much. And then you read it again and you're like, oh, it does this other thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So taking your time to read the cards and reading your opponent's cards, I think is pretty good too. Also, if you just tell people like, hey, I just started playing this a couple weeks ago, they're gonna get it. Like everybody's gone through the experience of
yeah.
like not really knowing how the cards work or
yeah.
just being new to Magic. It's like pretty overwhelming because it's like, oh, there's so many turns. I don't really know what happens. Like, I don't even remember the turn order. How am I gonna remember what your cards do?
Yeah, yeah. Or like when they do multiple things at in one go, I'm like, okay, slow down.
Yeah.
So I bought Aoife sweets to give her a little bit of extra motivation.
I have to say, having jellies and chocolate as an incentive to play really helped.
Aoife's been practicing with her mono red deck for a while now, and I think she's finally getting the hang of how to play it.
Now I actually know what's in the deck and kind of what I'm going to expect to like draw and stuff.
But she still has a long way to go before she can be competitive.
What are the struggles? I'd say probably the names of random things. So like prowess, menace, just have to figure out what they are and what they do. Yeah, I'd say that probably is the hardest part.
She's struggling a lot with remembering triggers and playing around what her opponent does, but she's going to a standard tournament at an LGS, so I think that might help.
Play in a tournament with people I don't know. Okay, I'm not a people person, so that's gonna be an issue. So I'd say it's gonna be a completely different story when I have to sit down with people who actually want to win and aren't there to teach me.
The War Chest is a really laid-back place to play Magic, and I think it might help Aoife.
It's a whole different ball game to actually have, like, I don't know, judges or, you know, like an actual structure. So I think that's gonna be different and just trying to get used to that. And then the fact that I don't actually know the person I'm going to be playing with. Are they going to be nice? Are they not going to be nice? And I don't know how competitive these things are. Like,
all she needs to do is remain relaxed and not get upset if things don't go her way. So I think she'll be fine. Probably.
Oh, I'm so tired. I hate you so much.
There you go, there she fits it.
Oh, I can't do it. Come on. I'm like, who this?